Monster Energy Supercross. I'm Jenny Taft. Now, recently, I had the opportunity to sit down with Carey Hart and his wife, Alicia, the Grammy Award-winning international superstar, Pink. Now, it was an amazing experience. I really enjoyed getting to know them and learning more about their family, but most importantly, learning about their love for Supercross.
Old habits die hard. I started my career as a motocross racer. You know, I wanted to be, back in those days, I wanted to be Jeremy McGrath. I wanted to be that factory supercross racer, and my path got steered into freestyle, luckily enough for me. It was the only way I could kind of get back into the sport, but and a long-term aspect was to start my own supercross team.
What defines the success of the RCH racing team?
Our goal this year with myself and Ricky is to have both guys in top 10. We're achieving that now, so that's a big goal for us on the track. And off the track, you know, we have milestones we want to hit. You know, we want to, you know, bring people through the pits. We want to expose our sponsors. We want to do as much on and off the track as we can.
What are your thoughts on the overall spectacle of Supercross? A lot of pyrotechnics and the pit parties. What do you think about the whole atmosphere?
It's a great Saturday night, and I love, the fans are hardcore. Mm-hmm. They're like NSYNC fans, but every weekend. It's awesome.
And they don't change.
But not about, like, boy bands, about, I mean,
intensity, yeah.
Stewart is their boy band.
And Carey, you won the Innovation Award 2 years ago at the Monster Energy Supercross Awards Banquet. What separates your team from the others?
Well, I think it goes back to when we first started the team. I mean, I knew for a fact we weren't going to win on the track. I mean, at that time, you know, we had some great riders, but these were guys that were just on the bubble. I mean, there was weeks where we weren't making main events, you know, so we had to start somewhere. I looked at Supercross as a completely different business model on my side, and to this day, I still do. You know, we started by, okay, if we're not going to win on the track, we're going to win off the track. We're going to have the fans coming through. They're going to want to seek out, find out where we're at, what we're doing. We created a fan base that has now evolved into the program that we have. Not that I want to, like, give up all my secrets, but we are very interactive. We welcome the fans.
And the fans are instrumental in this sport and their involvement. So how much have they helped you along the way?
This is a fanfare. I mean, without the fans, these guys ain't getting multi-million-dollar contracts. So you got to kind of take a gut check at a certain point. We're not curing cancer. We're putting on a show. Mm-hmm. So I think it's very important for riders, team owners, everybody involved to understand that this is a show and how can we make the show better.
How would you guys describe Supercross to someone who doesn't know
I have to do it every
it.
Weekend when I bring my parents over and over
Still?
And over again.
What do they think about it?
I think it's really exciting. It's fun. It's fun to watch people that have never seen it before kind of get into it and learn who's who. And I think it's really cool.
There's not much to explain. The fastest guy wins. It's super aggressive. There's lots of crashing. There's lots of exciting highlights. And it's pretty much self-explanatory. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, it's not one of these sports where stick and ball sports. I mean, there's so much to go to it, you know, so many rules, you know, so many regulations. This is the best guy wins, whether he's the smoothest or the most out of control. As long as he crosses the finish line first, he won.
Well, no, I want to know too, a little bit, you proposed, right?
I did propose.
At
the Mammoth Motocross race.
But you rode it on a pit board, correct?
I was supposed to be pit boarding.
I'm out there racing, and all of a sudden I see that her standing out there with the pit board. And I told her before, I said, she asked me, like, what do I write on this thing? I said, well, you know, tell me what place I'm in, tell me how many more laps to go, just the basics. I come around one lap and the board's hanging out there and it says, will you marry me? I see the sign. I come skidding off the track. The guy that I had just passed a lap before, I almost take him out as I come sliding off the track. And I kind of looked at her and she said, well, and I said, are you serious? She's like, yeah. I said, well, yeah, of course. And she said, well, get your ass back on the track. I don't marry losers.
Oh, I love that.
Then I got a flat tire. Half a lap later and came back and gave me a ride back to the pits.
I want to ask too about Willow, your daughter, and 2.5 now, correct?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
She's been at the Supercross races. What do you think she thinks of the whole spectacle of Monster Energy Supercross?
She loves it. She's daddy's little girl, 100%. She can't wait to put on her little race jersey and her little race jacket and in the car. Are we there yet? Where's Papa? Are the fireworks going to be loud? So, and she gets Pez every Supercross, so she has that to look forward to. We just create little rituals, and she just loves it. And watching these two run around after each other is darling.
When you're on the road touring, are you keeping up with Supercross?
He's either at Supercross, so I'm keeping up with him, mm-hmm. or he's watching it backstage.
Can't turn it
while
off.
While I'm doing amazing things,
yeah.
He's watching something else.
We gotta get the medal, so not the victory.
love it. I look forward to it. I can't wait till the season starts. I have such a blast. And especially now with Willow. It's just fun.
And what a night we have had so far here at MetLife Stadium in the New York, New Jersey area. You don't want to miss any of the action.